Hey guys, today I am going to walk you through the step-by-step process of completing the Tax Form 2042. This includes the people who are submitting their first income tax declarations in France. If you can submit an online declaration, you can check my other video about this process. The various resources to help you complete your tax declaration are available in the description below. First, let me remind you of the various income tax declaration deadlines applicable depending on your postal codes. For offline paper declarations, the last date to submit the income tax declaration is 20th May 2024 for everyone. If you can do an online declaration, the deadlines are different as per your postal codes. Here are the various income tax declaration forms published by the French Tax Department every year. You can download them from the links available in this video's description below. In this video, I will be explaining the main tax form 2042 used for declaring your worldwide income earned last year from January to December. 2042 is the main tax form to submit your income tax declaration. It has multiple annexure forms like 3916, 2047, etc. These forms are required to declare your bank interests, capital gains, rental income, and foreign accounts, etc. In France, we complete the tax declaration during the current year for the income earned between January to December of the previous year. This is the main tax form 2042. In the first page, you should start by adding your numéro fiscal. This is the French tax ID or TIN number. This information can be found on your tax returns from last year. If this is your first income tax declaration in France, you must check the box Premier Foyce as shown in this screen. You can skip the tax ID sections. The tax department will generate your tax ID when it processes your tax declaration. Then, you should add your personal details like complete name, date and place of birth, and contact details. If you are married or PACZ and doing a joint tax declaration, you must enter your spouse's details in the column declarant to wherever required in this entire 2042 form. Scrolling down on the first page, you should add your home address on the 1st of January 2024. If you changed address in 2023, you should also add the address where you stayed on the 1st of January 2023. If you changed address in 2024, you should add this address if it is different from the one on the 1st of January 2024 declared earlier in the top section. Henceforth, imports will send any letter including the avis d'import to this latest address. Moving on to the second page, you should start with declaring your marital status in section A as shown on the screen. If you got married, paxed, divorced, etc. in 2023, you should add those details too. Then, you will come across sections 1, 2, and 3. If you are eligible, they will add another 0.5 part to your tax household, based on certain conditions. These include single parents having children, disabled military pensioners, etc. In section B, you should check the box if you lived alone in 2023 and had children or disabled people under your care. In section C, you should declare the details of your children and any disabled people living with you. In section D, you should add the details of your adult children attached to your tax declaration. They must be less than 21 years old or less than 25 years old if they are students. If they are attached to you, they should not submit a separate tax declaration. On the third page of the 2042 form, you must add all your income from salary, pension, etc. Salaried employees can add the net salary before tax from your December 2023 payslip in line 1-AJ. If you were a student and did not earn any income during 2023, you can enter 0 in 1-AJ. This zero tax declaration will be useful for so many things in the future. If you had a student job, you must only declare the part of the salary that exceeds 5,204 euros in 1-AJ. If you received unemployment benefits during 2023, you must add them in the line 1-AP. If you worked as an intern or an apprentice, you must only declare the part of the salary that exceeds 20,815 euros in 1-AJ. There is a 10% standard deduction applied to everyone. But, if your total professional expenses are higher than this 10%, you can choose the phrase reels option. This can be done by entering the total expenses in line 1-AK. Scrolling down on page 3, you will come to the pension and related income section. You can declare the income from various government and private pensions. If you received any pensions from outside France, you must declare them in 1-AL or 1-AM as shown on the screen. These must be declared in the annexure 2047. Then, you can move on to section 2 about income from your movable assets such as assurance Y, interest, dividends, capital gains, etc. And follow the explanations as shown on the screen. Do not forget to check the box to OP if you want your income from movable and immovable assets taxed according to your tax bracket instead of the 30% flat tax. Moving on to the fourth page of the 2042 tax form, you can use Section 4 to declare any rental income from unfurnished properties. Consult the notice of 2044 or 2044 special annexures for more information. Scrolling down to page 4, you can declare the various charges eligible for tax deductions in Section 6. These include the family maintenance payments to adult children, minors, parents, and grandparents. You must add the details of these beneficiaries. If you have made any tax-deductible payments to your retirement savings accounts in France, you can add them as shown on the screen. Going down to the fourth page of the 2042 tax form, you will come across Section 7 about the various expenses eligible for tax reductions and tax credits. These include donations made to various organizations, including non-profit associations and political parties. If you are employing someone at home, you can declare them and get a 50% tax credit. Do not forget to add Annexure 2040 to receipt to explain the details of these tax reductions and credits. Moving down to the fourth page of the 2042 tax form, you will come across Section 8 about tax deducted at source and other things. In line 8HV, you can declare the total tax deducted at source from your December 2023 payslip, etc. Do not forget to check the box 8TT if you have any foreign insurance policies and similar products. Also, 8UU if you have any foreign accounts with banks, brokerages, crypto exchanges, etc. Moving down to the fifth page of the 2042 tax form, you will see the various options to submit an address proof. However, this page is applicable only to the people who are submitting their first income tax declaration in France. The sixth and the last page is applicable only for people accommodated free of charge by someone. As explained in the introduction, the main tax form 2042 has many annexures to add other relevant information. These include the tax forms 2042C 2044, 2047, 2086, 3916, etc. Links to these forms are available in the video description below. The purposes of these forms are explained on the screen. The tax department also published a detailed guide 2041 not every year. You can use this guide to understand the main tax form 2042. You must add Annexure 3916 if you have any foreign accounts with banks, brokerages, crypto exchanges, insurance policies, etc. It has a guide at the end to help with completing the form. The Annexure 2047 NK must be added when you have any income from outside France. The Annexure 2047 NOTS as a guide to complete the 2047 NK form. The guide also lists the various tax credit percentages applicable to taxes paid in various countries. The Annexure 2042 receipt must be used to declare the expenses and investments eligible for tax reductions and tax credits. The Annexure 2044 must be used for any income from your properties. If you have any income from crypto-related assets, you must declare them in Annexure Form 2086. When you have completed the tax forms, you can start preparing the total package to be sent to your local tax office. These include all the relevant tax forms, address proofs, your identity proofs, and the bank RIB. Do not staple any documents, but you can use paper clips to organize the documents. You can also add sticky notes at the top with short explanations. When the tax declaration package is ready, you can start searching for the address of your local tax office. You can find the address by using the official income tax office's directory explained on the screen. For submitting the documents, you can follow one of the methods. Option 1, send the documents by registered post. So, you can have official proof of submitting the declaration before the deadline. Option 2, you can deposit the documents directly at your local tax office. A lot of the frequently asked questions are answered on my website prasanthragopathy.com under the income tax category. You can also ask your questions in the comments below and I will try to answer as much as possible. A few examples of these FAQs from my website. And there you have it, the step-by-step process of submitting your French income tax declaration offline by post. Please subscribe and support the channel for amazing content about expat life in France and also other European countries. Remember, it's important to submit it on time and accurately to avoid any issues and penalties with the French tax department. Thanks for watching and happy filing.